It's been a little while since we last saw our final guest for today, and I'm sure at times he must feel like he's one of the loose lineup since we hear about him so much. Whether he's in trouble for using the downstairs loo or getting drunk on the ski slopes, he joins us today to fill us in on all things romantic. Please welcome the long-suffering other half of our very own Denise Welsh, Mr. Tim Healy.
How are you doing?
Oh, look, makeup.
Hello, lovely man. How are you doing?
That brings back memories.
Hello, you walrus of glow.
So come on. You snogged me last weekend, Sunday night you did.
When did I?
After the concert, remember?
In
the bar.
That's right.
In front of everybody.
That's right, that's why I had a rash.
So would you say that Denise is romantic, or are you the romantic one in this partnership?
Well, to be honest, we don't really take that seriously, do we? I mean, no.
What, romance? You make me a pie. He makes me a steak and kidney pie and puts my initials on it. Yeah. See, that's lovely.
Sometimes I put your name on the top and a heart.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yeah. What's the most romantic thing you've ever done for Denise?
That's about it, I think.
You took me to... When you were wooing me, and my sister was working on the cruise ships, and you took me to the Bahamas, didn't you?
That's true.
To meet a ship, you did that. That was about 97 years ago. Since then, there's been the pie, and that's been it.
20 years ago.
Well, Tim, one of the reasons that, of course, we've got you on today, because, well, I personally, I get loads of people saying to me, when does he ever get the chance to stick up for himself? So this is your right of reply.
Yeah, right.
So, first off, we'll start off with...
Where's the downstairs loo?
This about getting drunk on the ski slope?
Well, that's true, that's true. What happened was we went on holiday, but we took the whole family, didn't we? And it was the last day, and we went out to dinner on the last day, and I had to pay the bill, so they all went off. You see, it was a huge lot of people
there.
Lunchtime. Had a couple of glasses of wine, and then the guy, because I paid this massive bill, arrived with his thing and said, "Thank you so much." I said, "Oh, thank you very much." And I swore down that.
And then You'd had eight before we went to lunch. Well, you'd had eight shots.
This is his chance. Shut up.
And then I went down the ski slopes and I got to the bottom. And then I paid for all the ski passes for 14 of us. So another shot arrived. And then I felt very, very good by this time. And I got on the button lift, got to the top, and then got off and decided not to move and started to go back down. But...
You decided not to move.
And the rest is history, so it is true. It was on the last day, yeah.
I wonder what's all this about. She's trying to get you on a health kick to coincide with her supposed health kick.
Well, yeah, I think I have to. I've got to stop smoking. I'm really trying to stop smoking.
You read one page of your book.
I've got this new book, and
the reason I put it down is because I didn't really want to stop. Well, that's what you said last time on that aeroplane.
No, one once went out. That was all. That's when I stopped, when it went out. But,
Were you talking of going out? How long does it take you to get ready? Because apparently you take a bit of a long time.
Well, only in the mornings. I mean, you take a lot longer than I do in the evenings, don't you? Doing your hair and that.
But that's because you have about 17 poos in the morning.
Well, I'm very regular. Like I said last time, I'm very regular. You know, every morning, 7:30. But they all get out of bed at 9 o'clock, no, that's it. But, I like to take my time in the morning. I'm a slow starter, but then when I'm up and running, I'm all right, you know.
Same with sex, really, isn't it?
Exactly.
But is it the same with romancing? You know, what clinched the deal for you? Was it a foregone thing once you saw Denise after you got over the initial, well, she just looks like some blousy lass who has a glass of wine and a cigarette?
No, it's like she said, we got each other wrong, you know. I just realised that she had a great sense of humour and... I did have this terrible thing in the newspapers about somebody else, and she just laughed it off, you know. And I thought, oh, you'll do for me, you know, you realise that.
You didn't think it was terrible, though. You were quite proud because she gave you such good press.
Well, it was the timing that was all wrong. You know, I was trying to pull you with it.
What was it? A mixture between James Bond and Casanova.
From one to one.
I say.
Yeah.
And why do you think that's so funny? I think he is.
There you go.
See? You just don't appreciate a good man.
And I have to say, I like you better without all the hair, to be honest. I like this look.
Oh, yeah. I've made him cut that ridiculous hair off because...
Right. Yeah, looks See nice what good. I mean? I've made him. No, she's the biggest nag on
because
the planet.
I can't bear it. If people are going bald, they should just get it off. Yeah. Because it just... You don't look like that... Was that Mick Miller, that, you know, with just the thing round there?
Yeah, people, you get people that looks like it's coming from the armpit.
Exactly.
Like, you want the wind, it's like that.
And he did this for this film recently called Faint Heart, and it was exactly that. And they had to cut a step in this bit of his hair to attach a comb over on. And I made him sleep in a hat.
Well, it was funny.
We sleep in separate rooms anyway because you're snoring.
Well, I know.
But what does Denise do that drives? Come on, this is your chance. What does she do that drives you mad? Because you're so laid back with her. When I've been to your house, she's like, nee, 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 nee. And you go, why I pet, and all that. And you never ever go back. So get her back.
She does all sorts of things. Like, she'll never put the milk back in the fridge. You know what I mean? That. Somebody who doesn't put the milk back in the fridge. I take the milk out of the fridge and I put it back in the fridge. Nice. She leaves it there, and by the time you come to it, it's warm, you know? Mobile phone all day long. Ooh, ooh, oh, no, 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 no. No, no, my God, no, no. You know, he's sitting trying to read the paper.
But, Tim, she obviously does something right, because, you're still together. It's the most romantic day of the year. Right. Let's nail this, then. If you could have the perfect getaway, the perfect break, what would you do for her, Tim?
Well, she's in Paris. You've just had a fantastic deep massage. We'll go out to this wonderful Parisian restaurant. And there's a wonderful hunk there. Hunk.
Oh, no, I can't
sing
bear it.
Your favourite song you've ever heard. Sorry, I haven't got a hunk. I've only got me, but I've got Danny DeVito on the piano. Just come over, come over here.
Oh, my God.
Sorry, cop, you'll be all right. Sit on there. There you are, doll.
Are you going to sing
there
now?
There you go, doll. Sit on
there.
Shut up for 5 minutes. Have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you this road won't above you? You fill my heart with gladness. You take away my sadness. Ease my troubles. That's what you do. Oh, the morning sun and all its glory meets the day with hope and comfort too. You fill my life with laughter. You can make it better. Ease my troubles, that's what you do. The sun. At the end of the day, we will give thanks and pray to the one, to the one. Have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you, there's no one above you. You fill my heart with gladness. You take away my sadness. Ease my troubles. That's what you do. You fill my heart with gladness. You take away my sadness. Ease my troubles, that's what you do.
Thank you.